Hello my wonderful viewers, this is Ninetales Commander and welcome to episode 77 of Pokemon Battle Zone. So, I'm going to lead off with my good old Clefable. They're going to lead off with Ms. Magius, which is pretty sweet. So, they're going to go straight in for the Icy Wind, which is going to do diddly squat, but obviously he is going for the purpose of lowering my speed. But you know what? Since I can sponge hits all day from this Ms. Magius here, I'm just going to keep setting up Calm Minds because, well, why not? Might as well take this opportunity to raise my special attacks while taking special attacks better. So now my opponent is going to switch out their Ms. Magius and bring in a Ninetales. Why? What fantastic taste this opponent has. Yes, truly fantastic taste. You have my respect. Of course you do. So, I'm going to set up another Calm Mind. Even though I love Ninetales, unfortunately, well, I don't really see this thing doing much to my Clefable. Ninetales pretty much always goes straight in for the special attacks, and I need not fear the Will-O-Wisp, well, purely because I have Magic Guard and I'm a special attacker, so Will-O-Wisp is actually pointless in the long run. I have no idea why my opponent's even going for it. Well, actually, I do know the reason why. It's actually because they must not know that Magic Guard is a thing when it comes to Clefable. So I'm going to go ahead and fire off a Shadow Ball, and that's going to do a good chunk of damage. They're going to switch out their Ninetales now. I guess they got sick and tired of Will-O-Wisp constantly missing. But now they're going to bring in Ms. Magius, which is like, why? Why are you doing that? There must be a reason. Ah, they have a Focus Sash. So they end up going for Destiny Bond, which I actually feel is very clever. I don't fight Ms. Magius all that often, so obviously I'm not really, you know, I'm actually quite surprised to see them use Destiny Bond. So that was actually quite smart, though I do have to question, why did they even bother switching to Ninetales? Why didn't they just go straight for that right away? Or was it because they wanted to lure me out into attacking first and then go for the Destiny Bond? So that may have been the strategy. So they bring in their Ninetales now. Again, great taste, sir, though Rayquaza's blocking the view a bit. So I'm going to Mega Evolve now, which is great for me because now my Sceptile can take fire attacks all day due to now being part dragon. And this is not the same Sceptile in the last video, by the way. This is actually, it's not my Pattaya Berry Sceptile, just so you know. So they're going to go for Ninetales, and that's actually going to do a good chunk of damage. I'm actually surprised at how much that actually did. I mean, I know I'm Sceptile, but I expected it to do less than that. So anyway, I mean, it's not like he has a nasty plot set up or anything. Whatever. So they're going to bring in a Gardevoir now and trace my Lightning Rod. Good thing I don't have Thunderbolt. Actually, I can't learn Thunderbolt with Sceptile because it doesn't learn it. Don't think it would help much from it anyway, to be honest. So they're going to Mega Evolve now and go straight into their Mega Gardevoir. We have two Pokken tournament characters fighting it out here. So unfortunately though, despite Mega Evolving into Mega Gardevoir, it doesn't matter because I have the Energy Ball. And they surrender. Yeah, I'm not joking, they actually surrender, obviously realizing, hey, they can just use Dragon Pulse and kill me, might as well surrender. So, let's move on to the next match. So I'm going to lead off with my Celebi, because like, I very rarely see Celebi these days. I mean, I don't know if it's used much in competitive play, so I thought, you know what, I'm going to get a Celebi and I'm going to use it. And here's the end result. So I go for Toxic though, unfortunately, and yeah, they set up Substitute, which I did not see coming in the slightest. I have no idea what set they're running with this Superior, to be honest, but it certainly is different. I mean, how often do you see a Toxic on a Superior? I mean, I don't know. Is it a normal set? I don't think it is, but whatever, it's still pretty interesting. Unfortunately, since I'm Celebi, that means I have the ability Natural Cure, which means all I need to do is switch out and, well, yeah, heal the poison right away. So I bring in Sork. Yes, this is another Pokemon that is on my want list for Pokken Tournament. So yeah, I absolutely love Sork, and I would love to see it in Pokken Tournament. So anyway, I'm going to go for close combat. That's going to do a good chunk of damage, though unfortunately it's not going to be enough to KO. But he goes for Toxic. I'm not that bothered about the Toxic, because at the end of the day, well, you know, I'm an attacking Pokemon as it is. I'm very frail. I'm not going to last very long in terms of being attacked anyway, so I'm really not that bothered about the poison at all. So, plus I've got, like, I've used close combat twice now, which means I've already got my defenses lowered as it is, so it doesn't really matter in the long run. So another close combat is fortunately going to get rid of that superior, and of course I'm going to take some damage from the poison. They bring in the amazing Pokemon that is also Uber, that is Greninja, and oh yeah, why did you bring in Greninja? Actually, I do know why. It's because you didn't know I was Choice Scarfed. Yeah, I actually have Choice Scarf on this Pokemon, hence why I was just spamming close combat over and over again. I kind of have to, unless I switch, of course. So bring in their last Pokemon, which is Mawile. Shiny Mega Mawile is so weird looking, but at the same time, it looks really awesome. I should probably consider getting one. Unfortunately, I can't use it in normal competitive gameplay because Mega Mawile is banned from regular gameplay. So they go for Protect, which I think, okay. Right. Wouldn't it be better just to have attacked me right away? I mean, it's obvious I'm going to attack you. You know, I can't think what else I'm going to go for. But since I realize my defenses are pretty paper thin, in fact, maybe paper thin's too kind of a term, I'm just going to switch out and go into Celebi. And of course, I'm going to take a play rough straight to the face. And yeah, that's not going to be very helpful in the long run. And they go for Protect again, which is kind of annoying, but eh. Does it really matter? I don't think it really matters because, well, obviously thanks to Natural Cure, I no longer am poisoned, and I've also got my own Protect. So, that's kind of weird. So they go for Play Rough again, but that's not going to work because I use Protect. And now, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get some leftovers. So I'm going to switch out now, and I'm going to bring in my Sorc. I think at this point, I pretty much just brought in Sorc as death fodder, so I could just essentially, well, you know, go ahead and bring in the next Pokemon, since obviously whatever I've got left, you know, oh, it's Kyogre. Yeah, I can understand not wanting to risk Kyogre, since, you know, yeah, Playwolf could potentially want to KO me. I mean, it might not, but I didn't want to risk it. So I bring in my Primal Kyogre now. And now, there goes the Weather Shift, well, the Primordial Sea. And there goes another Protect. My goodness, dude, you love using Protect. I mean, I only bother using Protect in line with stuff like Leftovers and Toxic or Will-O-Wisp. I just don't see the point in using it with attacking Pokemon. So, there's Origin Pulse. That's going to completely destroy that Mega Mawile and score me another win. So, thanks so much for watching, people, and I will see you next time. Also, question for the episode. What Pokemon do you want to see added as DLC to Pokken Tournament? If you want to answer that, then go ahead and leave it in the comments. Anyway, people, see ya, bye.